history is one of violent transformations. Climate change, civilization, epic geological catastrophes have all broke out here. But this is not the end of the story. In this arid, lifeless environment, scientist Matt Lamana found one of the most remarkable discoveries in the Sahara's history. A massive ocean in the middle of the desert. There had been rivers and lakes before, but this was much older and much, much bigger. Matt's discovery began when he uncovered one of the biggest creatures on the planet.
We started finding bone after bone after bone. Some colleagues of mine, they thought that they were working on two separate bones, but those bones actually turned into one as they kept digging. And when we all realized what it was, we knew we were dealing with a very, very large animal.
The skeleton belonged to a Parallelepiped. Larger than a T-Rex, this giant four-legged vegetarian was the biggest of all dinosaurs.
Our best guess is that it was between 80 and 90 feet long and probably weighed between 40 and 45 tons. And an average African elephant weighs about 5 tons. So you can imagine Parallelepiped as weighing as much as the entire herd of elephants.
This beast required half a ton of vegetation every day. The landscape it lived in must have been incredibly different.
95 million years ago, we're in a shallow marine realm in a tidal channel. The tides coming in and coming out, it would have been like a tropical paradise.
This area was teeming with so much life that today, fossils literally stick out of the surface of the ground. So what else was living in the middle of the desert?
This is definitely the tooth plate of a lungfish. Is the base of a tooth of a sawfish. This is a relative of sharks. And then finally, this is actually butting up right against a piece of turtle shell right here.
This is evidence of marine life on a massive scale. An environment similar to the Caribbean today. So how big was this ancient stretch of water? Matt Gange has found more evidence, almost 1,000 miles away.
What we've got here are the feeding trails.